Now, in the previous video, I have given you a small example of where I can use underscrolls. So here I just created some examples where I'm just specifying what are the locations where you can use underscrolls and what are the places where you cannot use underscrolls. As I told you, after the Java SE 7 or any later version after the Java SE 7, they provided us a feature that in integral numbers, or you can say in integer numbers, we can use underscrolls in between the numbers. But as I told you, that in beginning of the number and in ending of the number, you cannot use underscore. So this is a small, actually in the previous videos, I said a small, this is a small mistake, but I'm going to correct that small mistake, which is about, I'll show you that, don't worry. So these are just examples of the variables where I'm using integral numbers. For example, if I write long credit card number, and I can separate numbers by underscores. This is perfectly fine. All these are actually perfectly fine examples. The second case, I'm using long security numbers again because I'm using this integral, underscore. So because of that, the readability of the code has improved. In the same way, using a floating point number here also, I can use an underscore like this. If I say long hex byte, so you can see that we have actually in long is actually of 8 bytes, right? So what I'm doing here is I'm specifying, I'm separating two digits here of an hexadecimal number with underscore. Now the next is long hex word. So you can see the word is cafe underscore babe. So this word, which is cafe underscore babe, so this word is formulated by using just hexadecimal digits. Okay, and just because of this underscore, the reading of the code, the reading of this number became very, very easy. So we can use this underscore to improve the readability of the code, or consider to improve the readability of the number. Now, in the next example, you can see I'm using long max long. So this is just the maximum number that you can store in a long variable. And here I'm separating them with the help of underscore, because by this, counting the number of F become very, very easy. Now again here, I'm separating a binary number with the help of underscore. And again, it's a very long binary number, which I'm separating with the help of underscore. So let me show you some of the examples of the locations, which is an invalid use of underscores. So this is just presenting a valid and invalid use. So the very first case is float pi 13 underscore dot 1415f. Now, as I told in the previous video, before this and after this, we cannot use the underscore. So here, the first two examples, they are wrong, because here we cannot use the underscore before the decimal point and after the decimal point. Okay. Next case, long security. Double 9 underscore double 9 underscore double 9 4 times 9 underscore L. So this is also wrong, because you cannot use this underscore after the number. Okay, so because before L I'm using the underscore, so this is not correct. Next is int x1 underscore 52. So this is also wrong, because you cannot use this underscore before the integer number. So because of this underscore, it will identify as an identifier. So it is an identifier. It will say this is an identifier which does not exist. So as I told you that in the previous video, actually by mistake I said this was identified as a string, but it is not a string. Actually this is an identifier. So if I do integer x1 is equal to underscore 52, so this is wrong. Now if I do integer x2 5 underscore 2, this is perfectly correct, because between the number I can use an underscore. This is perfectly correct. But if I write integer x3 is equal to 52, there is 52 underscore. This is also wrong. Now if I write integer x4 is equal to 5, any number of times I can use underscore and then 2. This is also perfectly correct. If I write int x5 is 0x52. Actually, if I write 0x52, that means this 52 number is an hexadecimal number because of this 0x. But I cannot use this underscore between the 0x, so this is also a wrong usage of underscore. If I write integer x6 is equal to 0x underscore, so this is also wrong, because actually this 52 number is preceded by an underscore, so this will be wrong. Now if I write integer x7, which is 0x5 underscore 2, this is perfectly fine, because between the number I'm using underscore. Integer x8 is equal to 0x52 underscore. This is also wrong, because of underscore I'm using by the end of the digit. If I write integer 090 underscore 52, this is correct actually. See, in case of hexadecimal number, if you are using underscore, here this is wrong, but in case of octal number, if after the zero you are using an underscore, this is correct, but still it is identified as 52 as base 8. Okay, so you can convert this base 8 number to base 10 number. Okay, so in case of octal number, after 0 you can use underscore, but in case of hexadecimal number, after 0x you cannot use underscore. Next, integer x10 is equal to 5 underscore 2, this is also correct. And integer x11 052 underscore, this is wrong. So you can find out what are the valid usage of underscores and what are the invalid usage of underscores in the Java integrals. Okay. Now let us look at the literals and the usage of underscores in the floating point numbers.